Welcome back to Career Power Hyderabad Podbard 247. Students, today we'll see the important MCQs. But before going into the videos, please watch the previous current affairs detailed analysis so that it will be easy for you. It's a follow-up video, a revision video. So before going into the video, also please subscribe our YouTube channel and also join our Telegram channel for the PDF and download our Career Power app. So we are launching online classes for Bank SSE RRB in our Career Power app. So we will provide the link in the description. Do download and share it with your friends. So let us go into the video. The first question for today. So what is the interest rate on the senior citizen savings schemes for the second quarter, that is July to September of 2021-2022? So what is the interest rate on the senior citizen savings scheme for the second quarter, July-September of 2021-2022? The answer is 7.4%. So yesterday we discussed the 12 instruments, the small savings schemes instruments. As a part of these 12 instruments, the senior savings scheme instrument has a 7.4% interest rate. So the next question, in 2020-21, India reported current account surplus for the first time in 17 years. So what is the rate of the current account surplus in financial year 2020, financial year 21? So what is the answer? So how much is the current account surplus recorded in the financial year 2020-21? Answer is 0.9%. So 0.9% is the current account surplus. It is the first time in the 17 years. So last year, 2019-20, there was a deficit of 0.9%. But this year, 2020-21, there is a surplus of 0.9%. So this happened because of the trade deficit, decrease in the trade deficit. So what is this current account surplus and what is this current account deficit? So surplus means exports from India are more than the imports into India. Exports are greater than imports. Then what is current account deficit? Imports are greater into India than exports from India. So we are taking more, we are buying more imports than selling more exports. That is deficit. So what is surplus? We are selling more exports than taking more, buying more imports. So it is surplus. So the next question, which day of the year is marked as the World Sports Journalist Day? So World Sports Journalist Day is observed on July 2nd. So on this day, we mainly acknowledge the work of the sports journalists. So they gave a lot of information to public on various sports, and also they helped in development of multiple sports in the world. So on this day, we celebrate July 2nd, we celebrate the World Sports Journalist Day. And on this day, in 1994, the International Sports Press Association was celebrating its 70th anniversary. So this day is launched as the World Sports Journalists Day. So this International Sports Press Association was formed in 1924 at the Summer Olympics in Paris, which is headquartered in Lausanne, Switzerland. So please buy heart all these points. So the next question, a Shopsy app has been launched by which company to help Indians to start their own online business without any investment? So Shopsy app was launched by which company to help Indians to start their online business without any investment? Answer is Flipkart. So Flipkart has launched this Shopsy app, so mainly to encourage Indians to be entrepreneurs. So their target by the year 2023 is to make 25 million entrepreneurs. So here in this app, you need to just register with your phone number. So this app will give access to nearly 15 crore products on the Flipkart website. So you can share hand-picked products with your friends or your customers via WhatsApp or Facebook. So if the customer is placing any order, then you will get a commission on every order. So likewise, you can be an entrepreneur without any investment, with zero investment. So Flipkart headquarters is in Bengaluru, formed in 2007, and Flipkart was acquired by Walmart in 2018. So the next question, how much amount has been pledged by World Bank for COVID-19 vaccine funding in the developing countries for the period ending 2022? So how much amount was pledged by World Bank for COVID-19 vaccines funding in the developing countries by the year end of 2022? Answer is 20 billion. So total amount pledged was 20 billion. So in the last year itself, in the earlier year itself, 12 billion was already released. And this year, 8 billion is released. Total 20 billion will be utilized by 2022, mainly for providing vaccines to the developing countries. So the World Bank President David Malpass has also urged the countries with surplus doses to provide doses to the developing countries. And also he urged the vaccine producers to prioritize giving vaccines mainly to the African nations, the developing nations. So World Bank is formed in 1944, headquarters in Washington, D.C., and you know the president is David Malpass. So the next World UFO Day, Unidentified Flying Objects, UFO. So World UFO Day is an annual event which takes place on, so the answer is July 2nd. So on July 2nd, the World UFO Day is celebrated. The main aim of the day is to create awareness about the existence of UFOs and a possibility for people to think that we are not alone in this universe. There are some others living in this universe with us. So July 2nd is celebrated because on this day, a UFO crash has happened in Roswell, New Mexico in United States in 1947. To commemorate this event, UFO Day is celebrated. So the next question. So Rafael is a defense company, advanced defense system company. So they recently developed the Seabreaker artificial intelligence missile with a 300 kilometer range. So this company belongs to which country? So Rafael is a advanced defense system manufacturer company which developed the Seabreaker's AI missile. So they belong to which country? So it belongs to Israel. So Israel's Rafael defense advanced systems, advanced defense system, they developed the Seabreaker artificial intelligence missile, which is a fifth generation long range autonomous precision guided missile system with a 300 kilometer range. It is 4 meter long and is it weighs about 400 kgs and flies at subsonic speeds. It can target both stationary and moving targets. So if you see some details about this system, this artificial intelligence enabled missile, so it has an automated mission planning system, automatic target recognition and acquisition system, and a multi-directional attack capability. It can neutralize a frigate sized ship with a single hit. It relies on artificial intelligence for decision making. It has an infrared homing, so which uses infrared to detect the targets. And also it can function day and night in every weather conditions, all weather conditions. It can be launched from sea to sea, sea to land, land to land missions. It has a data link support which coordinates with the operator on the ground. And this missile can work even in GPS denied positions, electronic countermeasures, laser jamming areas. It can work at any place. So this missile also has a mid-flight abort capability and it can assess the damage, battle damage assessment. So these are all the special features of this AI missile, Seabreaker AI missile. Also remember, Israel capital Jerusalem, Israel currency, Israeli shekel. So the next, what is the name of India's first indigenous drone defense dome system which is developed by the Hyderabad based Grin Robotics? So what is the name of the India's first indigenous drone defense dome system which is recently developed by the Hyderabad based Grin Robotics? Answer is Indrajal. Answer is Indrajal. So Indrajal is the first indigenous drone defense dome system developed by Grin Robotics. So it has a capacity of protecting an area of 1000 to 2000 kilometers. So you can see in news recently that Jammu airbase was attacked by drones. Drones have dropped explosives near the Jammu airbase. So this dome system, so generally it protects this entire area from these this unmanned aerial vehicles and weapons. So this dome system was developed by Hyderabad based Grin Robotics. So here this dome system can protect from the drones, UAVs and incoming weapons. And recent incident has happened at the Jammu airbase near the MiG-17 hangar. Okay, so there is an importance of this dome system. We need to study about this because a consequent news. So attack on Jammu airbase, then consequent news where a dome system was introduced by the Grin Robotics. So please buy hard. So next, Digital India initiative was launched by PM Modi on. So Digital India completes 6 years. So Digital India initiative was launched by PM Modi on 2015. So 2015, July 1st, Digital India was launched in India with an estimated budget of 1,13,000 crores. It's a flagship program of the government of India, mainly to make India digitally empowered and knowledge economy. So the slogan of government is IT plus IT equal to IT. Indian talent plus information technology equal to India tomorrow. So this Digital India program has completed 6 years. And in this program, multiple programs were launched. Diksha program for teachers, Enam program for farmers. Yesterday we discussed all these points. And e-Sanjeevani, telemedicine service, PM Swanidhi for street vendors, and digital solutions like Arogya Setu app, and also digital payments like UPI, Phone Pay, Google Pay, Bharat Pay, which we are using today. And for easing of operations, they launched eKYC, DigiLocker, eSign. So all these were provided for the empowerment of the society, digitally empowering the society. Also, we brought this Jandan Aadhaar mobile system where all the government schemes are directly going into the beneficiary bank accounts. So also vaccination drive was also made easier because of this Jam Trinity. So these are all the achievements under the Digital India program. So the next question, which of the following bank has launched the Salute Doctors banking solution exclusively for doctors? So which of the following bank has launched the Salute Doctors banking solution exclusively for doctors? The answer is ICICI Bank. So ICICI Bank has launched the Salute Doctors initiative. Mainly this solution, banking solution, will be mostly digital and instant. It will be provided from a medical student till a senior medical consultant. So everyone can avail this particular program. So it is powered by the ICICI stake, which currently has 500 services, and mostly these services are digital. So under this Salute Doctors banking solution, so doctors will be given a special saving account, a current account, and they will be provided three variety of loans, where home loan up to 5 crores, medical equipment loan up to 10 crores, as well as a business loan up to 40 lakh without any collateral. So these are all the benefits of the Salute Doctors banking solution. So the next, ICICI Bank headquarters Mumbai, and ICICI Bank is formed in 1994. So please buy hard all these points. So we'll go into the next question. So researchers have discovered a black-bellied coral snake in the Bagraj block of the Benno Wildlife Sanctuary. So this Benno Wildlife Sanctuary is present in which state? So Benno Wildlife Sanctuary is present in Uttarakhand. So in the state of Uttarakhand, a rare species, a rare coral snake, the black-bellied coral snake, you can see in the picture. So it was discovered. So this snake belongs to the Elpidia family. So the scientific name of the snake is Nigerventer. So this snake is mostly found in the Missouri Forest Division. So currently the world has 107 coral snake species, where India has 7. And out of the 2000 snake species, India has 300, of which 52 are venomous. So Indian venomous snakes belong to three families. You can see here the Elpidia, the Viperpedia, and the Hydropedia. So these are all the three types of venomous snakes. So all the snakes are protected by the Wildlife Protection Act. So the cobra, rat snake, and the checker kneelback were protected under Schedule 2. Dressed snakes are protected under Schedule 4 of the Wildlife Protection Act. Snakes, you know, are very useful mainly for medical and ecological reasons. So they maintain the food web in balance, because snakes consume rats. Rats can destroy the agricultural fields. So snakes indirectly help the farmers. And many animals depend on snakes. So it maintains the food chain, food web. And also, if you see the medical reasons, so snakes poison is used to create an antivenom. So antivenom is used when you have a snake bite. So this antivenom is produced from the big four snakes of India: the cobra, krait, Russell's viper, and saw-scaled viper. Also remember, the governor of Uttarakhand, Baby Rani Maurya. Okay, so the chief minister of Uttarakhand has changed. So we'll see in the next session. You will see who is the new chief minister of Uttarakhand. Next question. So which of the following bank has launched a Salam Dil Se initiative to show gratitude to doctors for their tireless service during the pandemic? So which of the following bank has launched a Salam Dil Se initiative to show gratitude to doctors? Answer is HDFC Bank. So HDFC Bank has launched this initiative, Salam Dil Se initiative, to show gratitude to doctors. So under this initiative, so the bank has launched a microsite called salamdilse.com. So you can log in and you can simply share your thanks message to the doctor. And this will be shared to the doctors via email, social media, messaging apps. So this is the Salam Dil Se website launched by the HDFC Bank. So what is microsite? Yesterday we discussed, microsite is a smaller version of the website which usually exists separate from the brand's main website. So microsite is a smaller version of a website. So HDFC is formed in 1994 and headquarters is in Mumbai. So the next, what is the interest rate on the Sukanya Samriddhi account for the second quarter, July to September of 2021-2022? So what is the interest rate on Sukanya Samriddhi account? Sukanya Samriddhi account interest rate is 7.6. So you can see on the picture, the interest rate for Sukanya Samriddhi account is 7.6. So yesterday we discussed all the 12 instruments of the small saving schemes. So go and check the video, you will understand what is that small saving scheme, when it is introduced, so how the money will be credited, or what will happen in those schemes, and what are the 12 schemes, you'll learn there. So go and check the yesterday's video. So the next question, Indian naval ship has recently conducted military drill with which of the following country in the East China Sea? So Indian Navy has conducted a military drill with which of the following country in the East China Sea? Answer is South Korea. So with South Korea, Indian Navy has conducted a military drill. So this military drill was conducted in the East China Sea mainly to enhance the interoperability between the navies and to exchange their best practices. So in this military drill, from Indian side, the anti-submarine warfare covert INS Kiltan, and from the South Korean side, the Republic of Korea ship Yongnam have participated in these drills. Also remember, South Korea capital Seoul, South Korea currency South Korean won. So the next question, YSR Bima scheme was launched recently by which state government? So YSR Bima scheme was launched recently by which state government? Answer is Andhra Pradesh. So the Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister YS Jagan Mohan Reddy has launched the scheme, the YSR Bima scheme. It's an insurance scheme mainly for unorganized workers between the age group of 18 to 17 years who are drawing a monthly salary less than 15,000. So they are eligible for this scheme. So under this scheme, so if there is a natural death, 2 lakhs is provided to 18 to 15 year age and 30,000 for 51 to 60 year age, and a 5 lakh accidental, if there is an accidental death, a 5 lakh rupees is given, and if there is a total disability, you will get 5 lakhs, and if there is partial disability, you will get 2.5 lakhs. So these are all the benefits of this scheme, and the other benefits include scholarship of rupees 1200 for maximum of 2 children who are studying 9th, 10th, inter and plus 1, plus 2 and ITA. And also within 2 days of the death, 5000 will be given for funeral expenses, and on the 11th day or the 13th day, the total amount will be credited into the beneficiary account. So this year, the government has, state government has allocated 750 crores, and in the past 2 years, state government has spent 1307 crores benefiting 1.3 lakh families. Also remember, Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh YS Jagan Mohan Reddy and the Governor of Andhra Pradesh Bishwa Bhushan Harichandan. The last question we'll see today is, so which bank has successfully celebrated its 66th Foundation Day? So which bank has successfully celebrated its 66th Foundation Day? Answer is SBI. So SBI entered the 66th year on July 1st, 2015. So if you see the background of SBI, for bank exams, very, very important. So SBI is first established as Bank of Calcutta on 2nd June 1806. Then it is renamed as Bank of Bengal in 1809. Subsequently, the Bank of Bombay in 1840 and Bank of Madras in 1843 followed the Bank of Bengal. These three are called the presidential banks which dominated the entire banking sector. So they merged into the Imperial Bank of India on January 20, 1921. So on July 1st, 1955, State Bank of India was established by the State Bank of India Act 1955. Earlier, Imperial Bank was a central bank and a commercial bank, but by the establishment of RBI, RBI becomes the central bank and Imperial Bank becomes only the commercial bank. So in 1955, July 1st, SBI replaces the Imperial Bank of India. So you know about SBI after that. So SBI chairperson Dinesh Kumar Kara, SBI headquarters in Mumbai, and you know SBI formed in 1955. So these are all the current affairs for today. So if you like our content, subscribe our YouTube channel, share with your friends, comment on the video, and for the PDF, you can join our Telegram channel. So we launched our app Career Power Hyderabad. So do download the app. We'll provide the link in the description. So bank, SSE, RRB related courses are coming up in this Career Power app. So do download the app, share the app with your friends. So thank you one and all. We'll meet in the next session.